Hello, everyone. My name is Jessica Leal, and I'm the training manager for our Americas region. And today we're going to talk about filters within our sensitivity assumption sets. So sensitivity assumption sets themselves are actually really, really beneficial because we can go in and create a set of assumptions that we want to apply to our portfolios or our different scenarios. And once we create them once, we can actually save them and they become global, meaning that we can apply them to any portfolio or any scenario that we want to. And so I actually have one open right now. I've named it Good Case. And in my description, I have written market because I'm actually making changes to my inflation rate and my market leasing profile. Now, once I've named it and I've gone in and I've chosen these assumptions, I can choose how long I want to apply those assumptions for and when I want those assumptions to start. Okay. So once I've gone in and I have created this set, I can then hit save and I can hit show results, or I can even apply it to a scenario. However, one thing to note here is that when we create this set and when we apply these assumptions, it is going to apply it to every property within this scenario, unless we enter in a filter and filter some properties out, which is exactly what we're going to do. What if we want to apply these assumptions to every property except those located in New York? We can actually make a New York market filter. Or what if we also wanted to exclude retail properties? We have the ability to do that as well. And we're going to do that through our filter feature. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to hit add filter. So on our ribbon, we have that icon. As soon as we click that, the first thing that we can do is we can name this filter. And I'm going to name this filter New York City Market. Okay. Once we've named it, we can then go down below and enter in the filter criteria. And we start that by clicking that little green plus sign. As soon as we do that, you're going to see that a formula of sorts really pops up for us. And it says address equals, and then you have the ability to enter in the address. However, you do not have to use this criteria. You can pick and choose what criteria you want to include in this filter. And we're going to go ahead and where it says address, click that. And I am going to choose city. And once we choose city, I can then change this from equals to a number of different options here. We're going to keep ours as equals, but depending on what variable you choose, some of these other options may make sense, such as is greater than or is less than and so on. I will choose equals, and then I'm going to enter in New York. Let's say that when it comes to entering in the cities, let's say that some of them you enter in New York, others you may enter in New York City. Well, you can go in and add in another filter and say, or the city can equal NYC. This way, you're just covering all of your basics and making sure that no matter how you spelled it or what you entered in, those properties will be filtered out. And then I can go ahead and I can hit OK. Now I'm going to have new columns where I can apply different assumptions to my New York City market. And any of the cities that fit that criteria are going to be included here. Also, I can hit add filter again, and I can say this filter is going to be named my retail market. And I can actually filter out my retail properties by once again clicking that plus sign. And where it says address, I'm going to hit that drop down and I'm actually going to choose property type. So you can see from this drop down menu that you have many different options that you can choose from. from country to currency, city and state, and also property type. And I could say the property type equals, and because these are built into the system, I have a drop-down menu here. So this isn't user-defined. We pick and choose the property type, and these labels are already within the system. That's why you have a drop-down menu, and I can choose retail. And once I choose retail, one last thing that I wanted to mention is that I can click show properties. And when I click show properties, all of the different properties that are purely retail are going to pop up here. So it lets you know what assumptions are going to be applied to these properties, or excuse me, what properties are going to take on these assumptions. So I can go ahead and hit OK. And now I have a third column that says retail market, and I can go in and apply those assumptions to that third column that I want to affect our retail properties. If you want additional training over sensitivity, we do offer upgrade training. So please reach out to our training team and let us know if you are interested to get a little bit more detailed in that sensitivity module and get one-on-one time to ask questions and really learn the ins and outs of these features. Thank you so much.